Good morning, students. This is Mr. Titus. Today we are going to discuss about animals. This is poem number 7 according to this book. And in this chapter, we are going to discuss a summary, introduction, as well as line-wise explanation. Okay. So, we have discussed a little bit, but today we are going to discuss a full poem. Okay, so let me discuss you with this in this this poem. So this poem is composed by Walt Whitman. Okay, so this is composed by Walt Whitman. And as for the introduction, he says like this, the poet Whitman praises animals for being better than human being and for possessing all such qualities that human lack or have forgotten. Those qualities are calmness, the lack of greed, and the ability to stay happy and contented among others. So, in this poem, we can see that there is a comparison of man and animal, means human and animals. So according to the poet, he give higher position to the animal rather than human being, because he says that there is something extraordinary power that animal kingdom possessed, but that couldn't possessed by the human being. Okay, so in this poem, Walt Whitman was beautifully brought about the contrast between animals and human beings. Animals are generally simple in nature, so whereas human beings are generally greedy, selfish, and very complicated. He is very happy with the easygoing nature of animals, and he wants to follow them. So these are the special quality of animals, and due to that reason, the poet want to follow to the animals, because first of all, he says that they are fully contentment. They have no greediness, they have no selfishness, all these things are there. So due to that reason, he wanted to follow them. Okay, who wanted to follow them? The poet wanted to follow them. So that was the reason. And further he says like this. The poet is desirous to live among the animals, as he think that they are contented and serene. They are wise, and this is the reason why they never bewail of their lot and condition. Very important thing that we found among the animals, and that is called the contentment heart and the contentment mind. You know that human being doesn't have contentment heart and contentment mind, because he has greed and he has selfish. Okay, he always want to have more and more. Whatever he gets, he is not satisfied with that. So he wants more and more. But whenever we think about animals, okay, whenever we think about animals, they are not greedy, either they are not dissatisfied. Whatever they have, they are living with happy. They do not weep for their sin, and they have no care of worship even God. They are always satisfied and do not need to possess things. They respect none, including their ancestors, and they remain indifferent in their pleasure and pain. For this very reason, the poet wishes to learn from animals. They do not have any kinds of flesh, and they are free from all type of tribal and ancestry, so they are still living their natural life. This is the summary of this poem. In this summary, the poet, already I mentioned to you, he says, okay, what he says, so they have no whip. They do not weep for their sin because they never do any sin. They never commit themselves in any sinful nature or any sinful act. They always do, okay, they always do what is they supposed to do. They don't do like human being, and they don't have covetousness, as I told you. They don't have selfishness. And so that the poet wants to learn something from them. Okay, he wants to learn something from them. So let us read the poem according to stanza. We will read stanza wise, then we will understand what the poet here says. I think I could turn and leap with the animals. They are slow, placid, and self-contented. I stand, look at them long and long. The poet here desires to turn into an animal and leap with them, as he is impressed by their calmness and the purity of their mind. Animals appear to be contented with their lives. The poet stands and looks at them for a long time. Okay, here we can see that the poet wants to change his life. If it is possible, if he can change his life, okay, if it is possible, if he can change his life to be just like animal, he is supposed to change his life like animal. So why? Because he thinks that they are contented and they are living peacefully. Whatever they have, they live according to their life, according to their position. They never think about anything beyond of their position. So they always want to maintain, and they always want to, they always wanted to live their life according to the facility in their, in their surrounding or in their family. Okay, whatever we may think. So let us read the second stanza. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Okay, so here is the second stanza. So condition, the poet is quite impressed by the animals, that they do not complain and cry about their condition like human. They eat and sleep. They have nothing to worry about peacefully. The animals are poor, and they do not pray to God for forgiveness or ask God to fulfill their desire like human. We human always pray to God, And we human, we have such desires, and we had some, you know, will that we want to get. And you know, some people, if I ask, why did you go to temple? Why did you go to church? Why did you go to mosque? Okay, so what did you ask to God behalf of you in the mosque or behalf of you in the church? Some of you can say, I prayed to God for a luxurious car. I prayed to God for a luxurious home. I prayed to God a luxurious, you know, anything. Okay, you can say laptop, mobile, anything else. So when we go to the mosque or when we go to the churches or when we go to the temple or any other religious place, we have many kind of heart's desire and we ask to God to getting that. But here we need to remember the animals, they never have such desire and they never pray to God according to their desires. Because whatever they have in this surrounding or in this nature, they are contented with that way. Okay, they are contented with that way. So this is stanza number second, and let me read for you the stanza number three. Not one is dissatisfied, or not one is demented with the maintenance of earning things. Not one kneels to another, or nor to hit kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. The whole earth. This is the stanza number three. The poet feels that animal represent human being in some way. This means that animals seem to have virtues like kindness and innocence, which human ones had. They symbolize the lot values of human race. The poet believed that human dropped these virtues a long time ago and have forgotten them. Okay, so many things he got, and but he forgot many things there. So in this way, and we completed our poem. So okay, I told you the summary. At the same time, finally, I would like to read the last stanza. Not one is respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they slow their relation to me and accept them. They bring me a token myself evens them painfully in their possession. Means they live in this world with happily, with joyfully, whatever possession they have, they maintain themselves according to their possession. Okay, they live happy life and they live a peaceful life. So I hope you have understood this point, and I would like to request you, if anyone yet couldn't subscribe this channel, so please subscribe and press the like button. At the same time, hit the bell icon also. May God bless you. Have a good day.